Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and last week I mentioned five more ways to use ChatGPT as a graphic designer, including a way to use it on your portfolio. But I want to kind of get a little more into the job search side of things, and I want to show you how to use it to create a resume and cover letter for whatever job you're applying for. All right, let's get started. Now they say in order to get the best results when searching for a job, you need to tailor your resume and cover letter to a job description. And as you can imagine, that can get pretty tedious. So we can have ChatGPT do the matching up of requirements and qualifications for us, and I'll show you how. Okay, so I'm here in ChatGPT, and to get to that, you just go to chat.openai.com. And you'll have to create an account and sign in and all that, but it's free to do that. ChatGPT is totally free to use unless you want to upgrade to Plus, which I have not checked that out yet. So here's the prompt we're going to use for the resume. Now this is kind of long, but ChatGPT kind of needs to know your information. So I'm going to paste this in here. Basically, we're going to ask ChatGPT to become a resume maker, RMAI for short. We're going to tell this new RMAI to ask the user for the following: education, the top four most relevant work positions and duties, technical skills, software proficiency, and then your portfolio. Also, you'll need certifications, additional training relevant to graphic design, awards or recognitions, and volunteer work or community service. Now, you can remove some of these if you want, if you don't feel they're necessary. And then it will also ask the user for the job requirements text. So this is something that I just copy and paste from the job description. And then it will create a resume with about 600 words. And this is the cool part. This resume should match that job description. So it's going to match requirements to qualifications. And we want this to use many of the same keywords in the job requirements so that these automated resume readers can see that we've used the same keywords that they used in the job description, which is a very good thing. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and press send. Okay, so here is what it's coming up with. We need to enter our education, the top four most relevant work positions, technical skills, and all these things. And then it will generate a resume for you. Now I've already typed out the first three, so we can just kind of test how this works. So I'm gonna copy all that, and I'll also copy the knowledge, skills, and experience required from the job posting, and I'll put that after it. Then I'll copy all of this and paste it into ChatGPT. Now, what ChatGPT is going to do is condense it and lay it out in a professional way. Of course, you'll still have to proofread it and check for any mistakes or anything like that, but overall, I think it does a pretty good job of kind of breaking it down. Now, the nice thing is that it's pulled out all these pieces that apply to that job specifically, based on the information and requirements that we gave it. Now, if you filled out your LinkedIn properly, you'll have everything you've ever done in there, and you can actually get LinkedIn to give you a PDF resume. Of course, it has everything you entered in LinkedIn, so you can start from there. You'll need to be logged into LinkedIn, then go to your profile page, and then choose more right here, and save to PDF. And it's created the PDF. I'm going to go ahead and go to that folder, and then we'll open this. Now I can give ChatGPT the text from this PDF and have it condense it for a resume. We'll use a similar prompt. With this new prompt, we're going to start off the same and have ChatGPT be a resume maker. It's going to ask us to paste in the PDF of information we downloaded from our LinkedIn profile, and it'll include all the same things. We're just calling this out so that ChatGPT kind of knows what to look for. We'll also paste in the job requirements again, and then RMAI will create a resume with the same number of words, roughly, a condensed resume that will have the four most relevant jobs to the job qualifications. And the descriptions of those jobs will use a lot of the same keywords in the job requirements. So let's give this a try. I'm back here in the PDF that LinkedIn created. I'll just click once to get inside text with this tool. Then I'll hit Command A or Control A to select all and copy with Command C or Control C. I'm going to paste this into the other document. This still has the requirements of the job description in it. So I'm going to copy everything now, go back to ChatGPT, and paste. So now it's looked at our experience and the requirements, and it wants to know which type of resume that we want to focus on. I'm going to do option 3. So I'll put that one in there. Okay, and let's see how it did. It did a great job of just picking 4 jobs out of the, 15 jobs I have on there, based on what I told it to do, which is emphasis on creative service management and art direction. And it's really condensed everything, and it does seem to be using a lot of the same keywords that were in the job requirements. So this is a pretty good start. I would definitely look over it and make sure, it didn't leave anything out. Okay, so now let's have it write a cover letter. And we'll do a similar style of prompt. This time I'm going to tell it to be job to cover letter, and then I explain what ChatGPT should do. Take job requirements and turn them into cover letters based on the user's skills. And then we want a 1-page double-spaced cover letter, and it should match the job requirements to our qualifications. Okay, so let's do this. Okay, now it's asking us for the job requirements, and now it wants the job qualifications. I'm going to come back to the resume and just copy the 4 job experiences that it chose. So now it's giving me the cover letter. And of course, we would have to fill out all of this information. And this is getting pretty long. I do want to have bullet points in this because having bullet points in your cover letter really helps it to be more readable. So I'll just say, please add bullet points with some qualifications. Now this time I don't think it did quite as well. This is not a format I have seen in cover letters. I see that in resumes more often. And I think it just listed a bunch of qualifications that are straight from the job description. I think that probably wouldn't be the greatest thing. So there's definitely some tweaking involved here. So you'll need to play around with it and make edits. But hopefully this will give you a good start. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.